for the Cadbury logo, and they are spending 1 million rupees for development at that logo or that particular design. What they have changed, they have just changed the font size. Not even font, just change the font size and the color that they have used. They have just enhanced the color. So for that purpose, they required to invest 10 lakh, means up to the 1 million rupees. So why these designs are very much important? Because whenever we are going to purchase anything or any material, the selections of that material is not only based on the utility or the efficiency of that particular material, of that particular product, but also depends upon that appearance also. We choose the articles or the materials that catches our eyes. So that's why these designs are very much important. So you can say when companies are competing at equal price and equal functionality, so only the design is the only difference that matters. एखादी गोष्ट आपण ज्यावेळी मार्केटमध्ये खरेदी करत होतो त्यावेळी जी लगेच आपल्या डोळ्यांना आवडते आपण लगेच परचेस करायचा प्रयत्न करतो अँड दॅट्स वाय द डिझाईन्स आर व्हेरी मच इम्पॉर्टंट. सो द वी कॅन से दॅट वन आर्टिकल विथ अ पर्टिक्युलर डिझाईन दॅट कॅन सेल बेटर दॅन वन विच इज हॅव्हिंग विच वी डोंट हॅव अ स्पेसिफिक डिझाईन. And that will be the profitable to use the design which all which will attract the customer. And that's why this particular designs must be registered somewhere. So nobody can utilize that design because that artisans or that particular creators have wasted some time to develop that design. And if anyone can use that design, so there is no use to develop the new design. So they will not get a proper benefit like a patent. If someone is investing their money, someone is investing their time to create something new, and if anyone can copy that, so it will not be beneficial to that particular inventor also. So like the same thing, if you are developing one design, now design is not just like a any article, it can be anything. There are different classes also, depending upon that these particular designs are classified. There are 33 design classes are there. So depending upon that, on which criteria or on which category your design fit, so that gives you the most strength. So why I am saying that, why these particular designs are why these designs are protected? Basically, under the Design Act 2000. Under the Design Act 2000, the objective of design registration is to see that the originator must be profitable. So the design which will not be reviewed in its reward by others applying to it on their goods without its permission. So like our patent also, without the use of the without the permissions of that particular creators, they will not use these particular designs in anywhere. Like we know, there are different logos, like Toyota will be there, or Hyundai will be there, for the Audis. So they have the specific logos. They have developed the design for the Apple. They are developing the designs. So suppose if anyone can use that design on their product, so there is no use to develop that design for, or they will not get the benefit they have already created. So the creativity will matter. So basically, as we have seen under the IP Act, that means where we are seeing copyright also. So there is some difference between the industrial designs and the copyrights. Okay, they both protect the artistic work, but here under the Design Act, they are only protected some designs which have the specific shape, which is having specific features. But under the Copyright Act, they protect the artistic work, like your paintings will be there, like will be like your poem will be there, or any compositions will be there. So that artistic works they have protected. So why these particular industrial designs are important, or what are the different aspects of designs that we are going to discuss? So basically, the objective of design registration is to see that the originators of a profitable design is not deprived of his reward by others applying it to their goods without his permission. So there is one law, Design Act 2000. So basically, law protecting designs was governed by the Design Act 1911, and which has been replaced now by Design Act 2000. So which is extended to the whole of India. Basically, that particular Designs Act which comes in force comes into force with effect from 11 May 2001. So that protecting the designs, those having the specific design. Now, where these particular design problems come? Mostly in a fashion industries. Sometimes any fashionable design can be copied by someone. So that's why they have to register, or they have to protect their specific designs. Suppose they have utilized that particular design in a specific movie. So nobody can use that particular type of design in other movies. So without their permissions. So for that purpose, this particular design, whatever you are creating, now designs means anything you can create means. But the one thing is that design must be visible. Whatever you are registering or whatever you are creating, it should not be just in your mind. You just have to apply that designs in some articles. So then only you can register your design. So there are various aspects also during the registration. What are the things you have to consider, or what are the other factors that you have to consider while registering your design? Basically, the rights that are confirmed by this particular Design Act and the registration of the Design Act 2000, which is called the copyright. Basically,
मी लॉग इन आहे इथे.
ओके, जस्ट वेट.